God be the glory for all the things he has done. We're excited. For so many times we have prayed and asked God to continue to inspire our young adults to take an active role in all aspects of our ministry, which they already do. But they have decided to take on this presentation of our annual Christmas program. Somebody say amen. Amen. For our youth workers, our children workers, we're so excited that they have taken on this effort in a great way. So I now present from the Fine Arts Ministry the greatest Christmas gift. If you agree with them, a great hand as they prepare for this program.
What? You got something for me? But Christmas in for 3 more days. I don't even know why we celebrate anyway. It's such a hassle. Why don't we just skip it this year?
You don't get the real meaning, do you?
Whatever.
Well, here. I'm sorry I didn't wrap them, but I hope you like them.
Oh, wow, babe. These are some very nice shoes.
Do you like them?
Oh, I love them.
Well, I was hoping that you would wear them to the Christmas service this Sunday with me.
I knew it was something. You ain't never bought me no dress shoes before. Now all of a sudden I got some dress shoes. I knew it was a catch to it.
No, that's not the real reason. It would be so nice to have my loving husband sitting next to me on Christmas Sunday. I mean, it gets lonely sitting over there. And by the way, the pastor's gonna come by and pick up the gifts and the cookies that I made for him and his family, but I will not be here.
Oh, time out. The preacher's coming by here.
He is coming here today.
But babe, you know the game is coming on tonight, Dirt, you know?
They gotta lose anyways.
And you talking about you gotta go? Where are you going?
I'm going to the ladies' Christmas party tonight. Have a good time praising the Lord.
I can't believe this. Well, what time is he coming by here?
About 6 o'clock.
And what time is your party?
6 o'clock. Okay, well, I have to go because I'm going to be late. So, I left the cookies and the coffee in the kitchen. Be nice.
I'll be nice, baby.
You will. Oh,
love
you.
Love you. See you later.
All right. Be nice.
Bye, baby.
Nice.
I'll be nice.
Very nice.
I should have known it was something. She ain't never bought me no dress shoes before. Talking about wearing a Christmas service on Sunday. Then all of a sudden she got the preacher coming by here and she gotta go. Man, I feel like I got set up. She knows dirty things, right? Anyway. Coming. Hey, come on in, Ram.
What's going on, Chris? What's going on, man?
Is it cold enough for you out there,
woo,
brother?
Man, it's plenty cold.
Come on, man. My wife made some hot coffee, some hot food. Come on, have a seat, man.
Oh, man.
So how's the holiday season going so far?
Oh, to be honest with you, brother, it's been busy. And I have a lot of work down there to do at the church. And, man, you should come. Christmas service, man. The kids are going to be singing. It's going to be a great service. And the boys are going to be doing a Bible. Christmas service.
Is that right? Well, I don't know about all that, Greg. You know, man, the holidays get so busy, and I just want to stay home for Christmas, man, relax.
Man, this is a good cup of joe.
Hey.
To be honest with you, I didn't come for the coffee or any of that stuff. I really came to rap with you.
That's what I was afraid of.
Well, check this out. Have you ever really heard a Christmas story ever told? I mean, like, in this season, we get so caught up in going to the store and buying and cooking food for the pastor, and cooking, and doing all that other stuff that we never have time to really enjoy the true reason of the season, like Jesus, you know?
I don't know about all that, man, but about all that cooking, That reminds me of going back to my grandmother's house back in the day when I was younger, man. She'd cook us dinner, and then we'd go to the living room. My grandfather would read us the Christmas story from the Bible.
Would you mind if I got my Bible out and read a few passages? I know it's going to be a problem, but let me read my Bible, just a few passages. It won't take long.
Rev, I guess, man, but you know the game is going to come over in about 10 minutes. We got about 9 and a half, brother.
Let me get the reason. Okay. As I'm reading this, Chris, I want you to think back. Think back over your entire life and over everything that our Lord Jesus Christ has done for us. And I want you just to reflect for a few seconds, okay?
All right.
You ready? All right, here we go.
Now, in the sixth month, the angel Gabriel sent by God to a city of Galilee named Nazareth to a virgin betrothed to a man whose name was Joseph of the house of David. The virgin name was Mary, and having come in, the angel said to her, "Rejoice highly, favored one, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women." But when she saw him, she was troubled at his saying and considered what manner of greeting this was. Then the angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. And behold, you will conceive in your womb and bring forth a son, and he shall be called Jesus. He will be great, and he will be called the Son of the Highest, and the Lord God will give him the throne of his father David, and he will reign over the house of Jacob forever, and of his kingdom there will be no end." And it came to pass in those days that a decree went out from Caesar Augustus that all the world should be registered. This census first took place while Cornelius was governing Syria. So all went to be registered, and everyone to his own city. Joseph also went up from Galilee, out of the city of Nazareth, into Judea, to the city of David, which is called Bethlehem, because he was of the house and lineage of David, to be registered with Mary, his espoused wife, who was with child. So it was that while they were there, the days were completed for her to be delivered. And she brought forth her firstborn son and wrapped him in swaddling clothes and laid him in a manger, because there was no room for them in the inn. Now there were in the same country shepherds living out in the fields, keeping watch over their flock by night. And behold, an angel of the Lord stood before them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were greatly afraid. Then the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy, which shall be told to all people. For there is born to you in this day, in the city of David, a Savior, who is Christ the Lord. and this will be the sign to you. You will find a babe wrapped in swaddling clothes, lying in a manger. And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of heavenly hosts praising to God and saying, glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill toward me. So it was when the angel had gone away from them into heaven that the shepherds said to one another, let us now go to Bethlehem and see this thing that has come to pass, which the Lord has made known to us. And they came with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the babe lying in a manger. Now, when they had seen him, they made widely known the saying which was told them concerning this child. And all those who heard it marveled at those things which were told them by the shepherd. But Mary kept all these things and pondered them in her heart. Then the shepherd returned, glorifying and praising God for all the things that they had heard and seen as it was told them. Now, after Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judea in the days of Herod the king, behold, wise men from the east came to Jerusalem, saying, where is he who has been born king of the Jews? For we have seen his star in the east and have come to worship him. When Herod the king heard this, he was troubled, and all Jerusalem with him. And when he had gathered all the chief priests and scribes of the people together, he inquired of them where the Christ was to be born. So they said to him, in Bethlehem of Judea, for thus it is written by the prophet. But you, Bethlehem, in the land of Judea, are not the least among the rulers of Judea. For out of you shall come a ruler who will shepherd my people Israel. Then Herod, when he heard secretly, called the wise men, determined from what time the star appeared. And he sent them to Bethlehem and said, go and search carefully for the young child. And when you have found him, bring back word to me, that I may come and worship him also. When they heard the king, they departed. And behold, the star which they had seen in the east went before them, till it came and stood over where the young child was. When they saw the star, they rejoiced with exceedingly great joy. And when they had come into the house, they saw the young child with Mary, his mother, and fell down and worshiped him. And when they had opened their treasures, they presented gifts to him: gold, frankincense, and myrrh.
You know what? Hearing about all these gifts, you know, the wise men brought frankincense, gold, and myrrh. But to be honest with you, church, we don't carry around that stuff anymore. What we carry around is Benjamins, Franklins, Jacksons. We even have coins that have Benjamin Franklin or some other president on them. So in the same sense that they brought their gifts to God, it's now offering time. and you can bring your gift to God.
Chris, let me tell you, every time I read this story, it touches me in a special spot. Just hearing about how Jesus was sent to the world, how God sent his only son to give us the gift of eternal life.
Reverend, excuse me for a minute.
Brother, what's going on? You all right?
I just wanted to make sure these shoes fit because I've made up my mind. I'm coming to Christmas service on
Sunday. Hallelujah! Man, I tell you, boy, that's good. That's real good. But let me ask you this. Have you accepted the Lord Jesus Christ as your personal Lord and Savior?
Well, whoa. I didn't say all that now, preacher. Hold on now. You know, my wife was always talking about that Jesus stuff, letting him inside my heart and this and that, but I always tune her out. I try to avoid it. You know, I have to admit, I really don't know where God fits into my life.
I hear you, Chris, but let me tell you this. It's by far the most important decision you'll ever have to make. And you don't have to wait until this Sunday to make that decision. All you have to do is admit that you're a sinner. Then ask the Lord to come into your heart, forgive you of those sins. And he'll do just that. And he'll give you the gift that surpasses any Christmas gift that we'll get this year. He'll give you the gift of eternal life.
You know what, Rev, will you pray with me for a moment? I think I have decided to make the most important decision in my life, to let Jesus into my heart so that I can experience the greatest gift of all, God's love, not only this Christmas season, but each and every day of my life.
Chris, let's pray.
Lord, you said that the angels rejoice every time one sinner turns their life around. Now, God, I know that you are so happy that this brother has changed his life around, that Chris has joined the army of the Lord. Lord, we ask that you continue to bless him. Wrap your loving arms around him. Let him know the true joy of salvation. And God, this Christmas season, we ask you that you give him the gift that surpasses every gift that we can receive, and that's the gift of eternal life. We ask that you wrap him in your loving arms, and that you tend for him, and that you allow us as a church family to continue to pour into him and nurture him. God, we thank you for his life, for his soul, and for everything that you're doing in him. Lord, we love him, and we know you love him even more. So we ask you to bless him still. In your righteous and holy and perfect name, in the name of Jesus, we pray. Amen.
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 Rem, I got to say thank you, man.
Oh, man. That's what they pay me big bucks to do. But listen, I got to run. I got to get back to the church. You know they'll burn that place down if I wasn't there.
I know.
But I want to let you know that I was so very glad that I came. Tell your wife, if she keep making coffee like that, it won't be the last time you see.
Yes, sir.
All right, man.
Thank you, man.
God bless you.
Thank
all
you.
Right now. All right.
Dear Lord, I just want to say thank you right now for saving a sinner like me. I know that I don't deserve your love, but you were so kind and you so cared for me that you sent your son Jesus into this world to die for me and save my life. I pray now, Lord, that you will continue to strengthen me, that I may live through you, and may it be a witness to somebody else, that they may come to you as well. It's in Jesus' name I pray. Amen.
Amen.
Baby, I'm so glad you're home. I got some wonderful news to tell you. Come on in. Babe, no, nothing like that. You know, the preacher came by and we got to talking and he read me the story of Christmas from the Bible and it brought up all these wonderful memories, like I was there experiencing it for myself. And you know what, when he was done, I made the most important decision in my life to come to Christ and I'm saved.
Hallelujah! Hey, yes! I've been waiting a long time for this day to come. Oh my God, thank you, Jesus. He has answered my prayers.
Thank you, Lord. And you know what?
Ooh,
not now that I've led Jesus into my life, I feel like I have a brand new song. Yeah. You know what? Y'all can hear me sing.
Song.
I was singing.
A great big hand. Hey, amen. No, y'all stay on up here. Thank God for our cast, Sister Michelle Atkins, Brother Chad as our innkeeper, Sister Wheeler as our reader, Deacon Coleman, Deacon Kazee, the preacher in the hat. Amen. Sister Williams, God bless you. Shepherd number one, Joseph. Amen, brother Ted. All right, let's give a hand for Mary. King number one, Deacon Banks. King number two, Brother Mark Coleman. King number three, Reverend Slaughter. I thank God for our angels, Sister Parnell, and our worker also, Sister Long. And thank God for Sister Alicia, and for the new convert to the faith, Brother George Lewis. Amen. Let us stand to the feet and give them a great big hand for putting on this Christmas production. May God bless you.